Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2253, Testing Excel Custom Visuals. Hey, welcome back to Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jalanway. Today, November 21st, 2018, it was 20 years ago today, that the very first tip debuted at MrExcel.com. Kevin sent in a problem where he had to convert these daily dates back to a month, and I used a formula on that particular day of equal A2 minus day of A2 plus 1. Why not the EOmonth function? Because back then, the EOmonth function was only in the analysis tool pack and not everyone would have it. Now, Black Friday specials, 20th anniversary specials, whatever you want to call it, click the link down there in the YouTube description for details on these three awesome things. Sale on ebooks worldwide, another garage sale for USA only, and a chance to get a free iHeart Excel sticker or the Mr. Excel 20th anniversary mission patch. Read the details down there. All right, so today, something awesome. And again, this is only for those of you in Office Insiders, right there, Office Insider. Everyone else will be getting this eventually. Microsoft has decided that they're going to allow us to start using Power BI custom visuals. Right there, if you have that plus sign is a great indicator that you have this. Now, to make this work, it's still in development, right? So that means that you have to go out to this other website that I'm going to put down there in the YouTube description and set up Excel for sideloading add-ins, right? Once you do that, follow all those steps. They have three sample files down here, right there, those three. Download those and you can follow along with this video. All right, I have no idea how to pronounce Sankey Chart. Sankey Chart, I have no idea. I'm going to select this data and we'll go to the plus sign, more custom visuals, and choose Sankey Chart, click OK. And it is a wild chart that shows flow of material or passengers from one place to another place. All right, so cool little chart there. Tornado chart. Now, this is funny that they made this be one of the items, because you can actually do this right now with a paired bar chart. But let's take a look at their version of this, more custom visuals, the tornado chart. Click OK. All right, so again, I've done this on the YouTube video in the past, even using data bars. You make one data bar go negative. And then the word cloud, this is pretty cool. You have a list of words and some volume, and you want to create a nice little word cloud there. Now, this is the one I've used the most out of all these. You've actually have seen some of these word clouds appear on the podcast before, so I have some great tips on this. Okay, so we select the chart and then come up here to format. That opens up a new panel with all kinds of extra things, and here under rotate text, you see that right now it's set from negative 60 to 90 with a max number of orientations of 2. Kick that up to about 7 or so, and you'll start to get something that looks a little bit better. You can change the data colors, get rid of stop words, all kinds of cool things. Now, I can't wait until, you know, these are massively available and everyone out there can create their own custom chart, but for right now, these three charts are fairly cool and a great sign of things to come. Well, okay, I want to thank everyone for being here for any part of the last 20 years. 2,200 videos, over a million questions at the Mr. Excel message board, hundreds and hundreds of Excel articles, 57 books. It's been great. I enjoy having this be my full-time gig. And I couldn't do it if you weren't watching. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like what you see in this video, please subscribe and ring that bell.